It's been a long road getting from there to here. It's been a long time, but my time is finally near. And I can feel a change in the wind right now. Nothing's in my way, and they're not gonna hold me down no more. No, they're not gonna hold me down. Cause I've got faith of the heart.
Having a bit of interaction on the Geek, discussing my cock-ups and rules errors. It's been very interesting. And thanks to Andrew for giving me some ideas as to what each of the civilizations should do in future turns. What I forgot to do at the end of the last video was the refresh phase. So we'll start with that now. The Federation, they will receive one production, one research, and two culture from their nodes, and they'll receive three production from their trade agreement with the Romulans. The Cardassians. Okay, one of the rules errors I made, or more accurately, the rules error I'm about to make, is taking production for Cardassia Prime when there's no ship in orbit of the planet. The occupation rule states that Cardassian control systems only generate production if there's a Cardassian ship in orbit. The way I've been playing it is that Cardassia Prime doesn't count for this rule, which was why I was happy for that last ship in orbit to go off exploring. But it seems I was wrong, and you do need to leave a ship there. So for this turn alone, I'm going to take a production without the ship being there. And then I'll get a ship back there sometime in this turn. So they will get one production, one research, and one culture. The Ferengi, they're going to get two production, one research, and one culture for their nodes. And they'll also get one research for the trade agreement with the Caldonians. The Romulans, they get one production, two research, and one culture. And from next turn on, they'll be able to take the trade agreement with the Federation. We have no ships in warp, so there's no warp tokens to add, and this pulsar's already got a research token on it. So that's it. I think we're ready to go on to turn three. Need the cards to shuffle. Okay, Romulans, fourth, Federation, third, Cardassians, second, and Ferengi first. Okay, the Ferengi, and they have the Ferengi Arms Dealer, so I can spend production instead of research to upgrade weapons. Unfortunately, they've only got two production, so that's not going to be much use to them. They do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 research. Was that 6 or 7? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, 6 research. I'm wondering whether I should upgrade my shields or add a research here. The plan for the Ferengi this turn is to go out and meet up with the other civilizations, so I think it'll be probably be safer if we upgrade their shields. So that uses all the 6 research. They're going to also spend a culture on this ship. And colonise that planet. And they'll spend 2 production to pop a production number. And that's going to be it for the build phase. Before we move on to the command phase, we need to pass this card to the left, which will be moving it on to the Romulans. So the Romulans now are going to have to test their diplomacy to see if they're going to be able to use this card. This is something that was discussed on the Geek. I know some people were just passing the card around without testing each civilization's diplomacy level, but I think I prefer it that you do have to test. So, not much of a test. As long as they don't roll a 1, they'll be fine. Excellent. So, that card goes away. Right, Ferengi, so spend a couple of commands, they're going to put this ship into warp, try and meet up with the Cardassians. 3. Yep, that's going to be fine. Go. There we go. So they've now made contact with the Cardassians and they're going to offer them a trade agreement. Okay, Cardassians have got all the 3 trade cards still left. So obviously the Ferengi are going to try. They'll try and get a 3 trade agreement. Cardassians will not be too keen on that, so they will only accept that if they get a 1. It's a 4, so they won't accept that. Ferengi will try again, try and go for a 2. Again, Cardassians not too keen. Anything 3 or above, they'll accept, deny it. So they got a 2, which yet they will accept that. So the Cardassians will give the Ferengi 2 production card for the Ferengi trade agreement. During resource generation, take 1 production for each system you control with Ferengi in orbit. So this is the difference with the Ferengi trade. They don't automatically get trade. They have to allow the Ferengi into their systems. And for each system containing a Ferengi ship, they will get 1 production. Ferengi will then try and join this one up again. We need to spend 2 commands. A 3. To there, and they'll try the same again with the Romulans. So Romulans, so the Ferengi will try for another 3. Romulans will only accept on a 1. 5 they don't accept. They'll try for a 2. Romulans will accept anything below a 2. That's a 5, so they don't. So They will do the trade, but it will be for one trade agreement. There's one command left. There's no Cardassian or Romulan systems that can move into. What they will do, the Cardassians tell them to move into Flugtar asteroid. So they'll spend the command and impulse into the asteroid field. So they need to roll. Just looking now, when I upgraded the weapons by mistake. It was the shields we upgraded. So they have shields of +1, so they can move straight into the asteroid field without any fear of being destroyed. And that is the end of the Ferengi turn. Okay, now we move on to the Cardassian turn. Right, we're going to have to get this colonised. So unfortunately, I'm going to have to disband that Overseer fleet. Disband the fleet to colonise the Flugtar asteroid field. Okay, we got 2 production. So we'll spend the 2 production on 2 ships. Forgot to spend the culture. Colonising that, so we'll spend that culture. I think what I'm also going to do, I'm going to spend another culture on this ship. Colonise that. We got 3 research tokens. We need to get some research started. We got 3 culture left. Okay, let's move on to the command phase. I'm going to spend 2 culture, pop this guy into warp, and we'll see about meeting up with the Federation. 2. Go and start diplomatic relations with the Federation and offer them a trade agreement. We have a 1 and a 3 left. One of the Federation got a 2 and a 1. Cardassians will offer the Federation a 1 trade agreement for their 2. Federation are bringing in 4 production a turn, where the Cardassians are just at present, they're probably looking at 2. Federation will accept that on a 1 or a 2. 5. They decline. Cardassians, they don't really want a 1 for a 1. I think they're going to have to accept that. Okay, so it's a 1 for a 1. Cardassians are going to spend a command, take a look at starting some research. Sensor ghosting and hollow projections. During a space battle, exhaust this card to force a rival to reroll all hits they've scored this combat round. This may be used on a rival's round. Okay, that's a nice one. Covert military bases. During your building phase, you may build up to 3 ships in an uncontrolled system. Wow, that's a good one too. Let's go for that one. And spend another 2 command. Put one of these into warp and send them off over there. 3. Terra Nova. Nice one. crisis. Lights of Zatar. The Zatarans have searched space for thousands of years, seeking sentient life whose consciousness they can supplant. If you have two or more warp tokens pictured on your advancements, you don't, this card has no effect. If not, ships in this system must brave a level 4 hazard. Okay. They haven't upgraded their shields. 3. Yes, they're fine. They got one command left. I think they're going to build a space station here. She'll give them an extra command. And that is the end of the Cardassian turn. The Federation, they have 4 production. Loads of research. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 research. They're going to spend 6 to upgrade their shields. They'll place 1 on this tachyon detection array. And that's it. Is it? No, it's not. They are going to spend 1 culture and the ship to colonize that planet, and then spend a production and 2 culture to build a culture node. They got 3 production left, and they're going to build a colonization fleet. And then with the colonization fleet, they're going to move to Magna Roma, which is going to cost 1 to go into warp, and then another 3 to come out to warp at Magna Roma. Roll the dice, it's a 4. Command, disband a fleet to colonize that planet. That's the end of the Federation turn. Romulan turn, we got 1 production, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 research. Let's have a look. We've got the advanced Romulan cloaking device. Tal Dian security forces. In planetary invasions, research nodes you control roll an additional die to hit. Right, let's stick research on those, I think. Got 3 left. Right. 1 production. What do we want to do with that? I think what we'll do with that is spend the production and 2 culture to build a culture node there. Then we move on into the command phase. In actual fact, before we move on to the command phase, we're going to spend another culture on this ship. And in the command phase, I'm going to pop the fleet into warp. Delta 4, blimey, more research. Oh, and it's a pre-warp level 0 civilization. And I pop 1 production and 1 culture on there. Great. So that's ripe for colonization by the Romulans. So the Romulans have met up with the Ferengi and Federation so far. They could, yeah, let's go for meeting up with the Cardassians. But what we'll do first is I'm going to disband this. Commands. Two. That's nice. That should fit fine. Yep. Pop in there. And they'll open up negotiations. Cardassians have only got a trade agreement worth 3 production. The Romulans have got a 2. So, yeah, they'll go for that. So, just about everybody's trading now. The only one who hasn't met up are the Ferengi and the Federation. And let's see, they've got one command left. They've got 2 advancements being researched and 2 research nodes, so we can't do any more research. What we could do, could build a space station. Do we build it on Streleb Medina or Corridan 3? I think we'll build it on Streleb Medina. There we go, so that gives them an extra command. And we'll go on to the recharge phase. The Ferengi get 3 production, 1 research and 1 culture for their nodes. They get 1 research for the trade agreement with the Caldonians. They get another 3 production for the trade agreements with the Romulans and Cardassians. And they get 1 more production for having a ship in this Cardassian system. Cardassia, they get 1 of each for the nodes. They get 3 for the trade agreements with the Romulans and the Federation. And they get 1 from the Ferengi trade agreement for the Ferengi ship being on the Vluktar asteroid field. Federation, they get 1 production, 3 culture, and 1 research for their nodes, and 4 production for their trade agreements with the Cardassians and the Romulans. Romulans get 1 production, 2 culture, and 2 research for their nodes, and that's the end of the turn. On to the next turn. Romulans, 4th, Federation 2nd, Cardassians 3rd, Ferengi 1st. So the Ferengi, they've got a nice load of production, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 production. They'll spend 1 of the research and pop it on the... They're then going to spend 5 production to build a franchise establishment flotilla. While moving, you may remove ships from this fleet and place them in any system the fleet moves through. If this fleet drops below 3 ships while moving, it disbands after moving. And he will go there. Right, we'll move on to the command phase. Spend command to drop him into warp. Let's and a command to pop him into loop. Spend a command, pop him into warp. And another two to move him one and two. And that is the end of the Ferengi turn. Federation, we've got one, two, three, four, five production, one research, four culture. Pop the research on here. Right, they're going to spend two production to build a production node here. And they're going to spend three production to build another colonization fleet. The idea behind that is that I want to get this colonized. Because once the Cardassians get the covert military base advancement, I don't want any systems near Earth that they could just suddenly build ships in. So we'll get that colonized, even though it's not that good a system. What else? Nothing much else we can do. We could ascend. In fact, yeah, we may as well. Because I don't need the culture to colonize that planet. I'm already building on all the culture spaces I can. Yep, so we've got four culture, so we'll ascend. So there's two ascendancy now for the Federation. Move on to the command phase. Move out that colonization fleet and then disband it. Two commands left. I'm thinking of building a star base here to defend that. But I think that might be a bit, that could go down as pretty provocative to the Romulans if I did that there. Yeah. I'm going to spend one command. I'm going to build a star base there. Gives us an extra command. One command left. Can't do any more research. I think that's going to be the... No, what I'll do, I'll spend the final command and I'll put one of these ships into warp. There we go. And we move on to the Cardassians. We got one, two, three, four, five production. Four research, four culture. We'll pop a research on here. Gonna spend two production to build two ships there. Gonna spend two more production to build a production node. Spend another production to build another ship there. And then we'll move on to the command phase. Going to spend one command to bring this fleet together into the Overseer fleet. Which will allow them to double the production here. And spend one command to bring him back into there. No shields, so we don't want a five or more. Oh, close, it's a four, we're fine. Spend two commands to move this ship to there. And spend two more commands to Send this ship out that way. Two. Briary patch in space battles only rolls of six hit ships in this phenomenon. Okay. Don't want a five or more. Search there then. Right, we've got one command left. We could go up an ascendancy, and then we could build a star base here on Terra Nova between us and the Romulans. So, spending the fuck. Oh no, we don't want to do that, we want to save the culture. No, so we'll leave it there. And we'll move on to the Romulan turn. Okay, Romulans. Four production. Three, four, five research. And three culture. So, what else do we want to do? What do we want to build? Right, I think we're going to start by colonizing this. So that's a ship and a culture, which gets us back our culture and a production. And we will spend two research and a production. Get some more research nodes. And we're going to spend two more production to get another production node. We've got two production left. Oh, the Romulans do not like that starbase so close to their homeworld and the three Federation ships. Spend the two production on two more ships. And then we will, we're gonna go out to explore, I think. So we'll spend two command, popping into warp. Two. Rog. And that can only have one space lane on it, so that's a dead end. Oh, five. And they haven't upgraded the shields. Brilliant. Boom, gone. Must remember an exploration card there. Two commands left. I don't know what to do with them. Right, they have got three research nodes now, so let's spend a command to do some more research. Superior targeting array. Your ships and nodes may re-roll one to hit roll in each round of combat. Okay. Tal Shiar. On your turn, you may exhaust this card to exhaust a rival's espionage or military advancement with whom you've made contact. Okay. Well, you've made contact with everybody. So that comes in and with everybody. Military and espionage. That would be good against the Cardassians. And yeah. Yeah, that one. Go for this one. think we'll end the Romulan turn there. So the refresh phase, starting with the Ferengi, we got three production, one culture and one research node. We get three production for these trade agreements. We get a production for ships here and a production for having a ship there. And that's it for the Ferengi, I think. Federation, we have two production, three culture and one research, and four production for the trade agreements. Cardassians, we got one production here, one doubled for the overseer, so that's three production, one culture and one research. Reproduction for our trade agreements with the Romulans and the Federation, and one production for our trade agreement with the Ferengi because of the ships in our system. Romulans, we have one, two production, three research and two culture nodes. We got six production coming in from trade agreements with the Cardassians and the Federation, and one from a trade agreement with the Ferengi. And that's going to be it for now. Thank you very much for joining me again for the second episode. Again, if you've seen me make any mistakes or any cock-ups, Andrew, I'm sure you'll have another go at me for some probably major cock-ups I've made. But there we are. I'm big enough and ugly enough to take it. And if there's anything going on which you're interested in putting some comments about what you think the civilization should do, then I'd be happy to hear it. So there we are. Thanks for joining me again, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
It's been a long road, getting from there to here. It's been a long time, but my time is finally near. And I can feel the change in the wind right now.